So today I'm driving the car to work this morning, and the oil light came on, low oil pressure came on the infotainment center, and it started clocking shortly after that, making loud noise and everything. So I want to take the time and show you guys what it is. You're going to be surprised, because I thought it was the oil pump that shit the bed, but it wasn't. Let's go take a look at it. On these cars, there's something called a camshaft sensor synchronizer, and that's what will let go. And it's also, this part here runs the oil pump. If you see the synchronizer gear, it is worn right out. Look how thin those teeth are. That's pretty much what caused the oil pump to not to work, but the car still ran pretty good. So if this wasn't spinning for the camshaft sensor, I don't know why the car ran so good. I mean, it's for, you know, until it started clocking because it wasn't getting oil. Now, I don't know if I ruined the engine or not. Your best bet, if you do have something like a low oil pressure light comes on, just to pull the vehicle over. I didn't do that. Wanted to get to work, whatever, but I didn't make it either way. So the sensor is right here. This is where it goes in. I don't know if you can see the hole down in there. That's where it actually goes in. But what I did was I marked this in the exact spot it was in before I even took it out. So I marked that, as you can see right there. And then I marked this piece here to the engine right there. See that mark? So I know it'll go back exactly in the same way it came out. Now to take this out, this is gonna come off, right? The camshaft sensor itself comes off. Disconnect it, disconnect the electrical plug. And then you take these two screws, that just sits right on top of this here, just like that. And then to get this out, there's a washer that sits down there with a screw. You gotta take this screw out, which just sits on the lip like that. It's real easy to get to with a flex socket, and this just slides right up. What you wanna do is take these wires and stuff and use a screwdriver like I have here to hold the wiring out of the way, and you can just put it right inside and take it out. All right. To get this thing in, you're gonna have to find what's called top dead center on the engine. Now, number one spark plug is on this side here, right? The side against the firewall. It's hard to get in there, but you're gonna have to take out that number one plug. Then you're gonna put your finger on there and have someone just tap the key slightly till you feel air coming out of that spark plug hole. Once that happens, you know the number one cylinder is on the compression stroke. And now you go to find top dead center. Top dead center is right down by the pulley on the bottom. Since it's difficult for me to show it to you here, I'm gonna bring up some pictures right now and I'll show you to you. Top dead center marking, or the mark where on the engine block, is right here. That's where you're gonna match the top dead center mark from the pulley itself, or the harmonic balancer. So if your car is like my car and you can't see the markings on the pulley anymore, I'm gonna give you a little secret that's gonna get you on top dead center. Now you're gonna see there's a gap between the teeth. At that point, you're gonna count to five teeth to the left of the pulley. That's the mark, or the tooth, that you wanna line up with the mark on the engine. And that'll be your top dead center. Tooth number six will be right underneath, directly underneath the crankshaft sensor. Once you get that lined up, you're going to use the tool and get that camshaft synchronizer back into its hole, lined up correctly. So that tab that spins around for the sensor, that's going to be like right in the middle of the space for the where the sensor sits on. So take a look at this picture. That's where it's going to be. So once you get that camshaft sensor on, you just hand tighten it. Put the plug back in for the sensor. And I took the wires out, so I'm going to put the spark plug wires back in. Took them off to get them out of the way. And now we're going to start this up and see if we have oil pressure. Check engine light's still on. That's when it came on for the low oil pressure, but I got no more low oil pressure there. And the oil pressure light is out. Now, if I could just get this engine to quiet down. Got a hell of a tick noise.
I just want to show you, if you have a bad camshaft synchro, you're going to come up with these codes, or you probably will come up with these codes. P0340, camshaft position sensor. And you're going to get a P1336, most likely, crankshaft position system variation, not learned. So those are the two codes that will probably come up if that camshaft sensor synchro is bad.
It'll run either way, whether it's on, it's in right or not. But if it's not in correctly, you will get a code on a computer. If you get that camshaft code, then you know that this is not correct. You probably don't have it on top dead center. So what you're going to do is get it back on that top dead center where the everything lines up like before. Take the synchronizer out. Turn the pulley down at the bottom, a harmonic balancer, back over one full turn to the number five tooth, and you should be top dead center. You were probably off. That's probably why you're still getting a code. But once you get this engine on top dead center and you get that cam synchronizer in correctly, you won't get any more crankshaft codes and she'll run like a top. So there you have it. She's quiet like a kitten. I am surprised because I drove this thing for like 15 miles with no oil pressure. I tell you, these 3.0s, they're good engines, man. They take a beating. She's idling great. She's quiet. I don't recommend you do that. So if your oil light comes on, pull it over, have the car towed. But don't let somebody tell you you need an oil pump, because it could be just the camshaft synchro gear.